Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Untamed Chaos. As you might be able to tell from the room here, this is going to be another episode about blood magic stuff. So since the last time I did blood magic, I've been looking into a lot of different things, mainly how to upgrade and take stuff a bit further, and to do that, I need to summon stuff. And as you might have been able to guess, I talked about this area. I'm not sure if I ever said it was for summoning, but yeah, that's kind of what I've been playing out this area for. Why I moved the farms and wanted to give this a bigger place was because I need to make a summoning area. And I also would like to set up the ritual binding over here and maybe unbinding if there's room. I don't know, it's not a big deal. I might just do those off camera if I don't have a lot of time, because I am recording this after I did the last episode of redoing this base, and as I said, that took 2 hours, so my voice is already a bit tired. But I did set up the beacons then and redo the farms and make pathways and a lot of cool stuff, as you can see. And yeah, the regeneration will probably help a lot with getting blood. I might not even need the ritual of regen. I'm not sure if the ritual of regen would even stack with this and give me regen 2. Probably not. I also could upgrade the ritual to give regen 2, but I don't know, it's not a big deal now that I have the beacon anyway, so that might help and give a bit more blood anyway, so I'm not using blood to make regen. And also the strength and resistance should help with what I need to do this episode. So yeah, also before I get into things, I did refill my blood off camera, so it's now should be back to 1 million, I think it is. And I also made some spare catalysts, because they're going to be used a lot in stuff I'm going to be doing now in blood magic. And I did test the sigils and the rituals off camera. This one has a really cool effect. Pretty much what it does is if an Enderman tries to teleport, it can't. So it blocks all Endermen, maybe mobs, maybe myself. I didn't test it too much. I just pretty much looked it up and saw what it does. So if an Enderman tries to teleport, it won't teleport. I'm not sure if it applies to other things, but I think that's a really cool effect because I will be needing to fight some Endermen soon in the future. And compression, it doesn't really work well. Like, it's supposed to pretty much take an item and craft it itself 9 times, like turn diamonds into a diamond block. But I could never get it working reliably. Like, I tested around by picking up items, dropping items, turning it on and off. Occasionally, it would craft one block, but it wouldn't keep going. So I'm not sure how to really get it working. And I'm just going to say, let's just kind of ignore it, because I really don't need it at the moment, because I do have compression drawers and other autocrafting means. So it was cool to try it, but it really just doesn't work well. And I think it's just in this version of blood magic, which is the latest for 1.7. I think it's also the last for 1.7, because Way of Time's moving on to 1.8, I believe. Maybe wrong. So I don't think it's going to be any more stable or update wise. And unless I'm just doing it horribly wrong, it just doesn't really work. So the first thing I need to do this episode, I already made the arcane pedestals here, which were like this, but I need to upgrade this a bit further into an arcane plinth. I think that's how you say that word. And I was looking up pedestal because I couldn't tell apart from the Thaumcraft arcane pedestal because they're the same name. So yeah. I don't know, probably could have came up with a better name than Arcane Pedestal 2 or something like Blood Pedestal or Demon Pedestal. I don't know. So this goes here, and these go around it like this. So all these torches you've been seeing were guides for where to put this stuff. And as I have said in the previous episode, I will make this area look better in the future. And these were for later pedestals, by the way. I could make them now. How about I actually just do that real quick and grab obsidian and make them, just so we can kind of see how the area fully looks. It does go out 3 times, or twice, actually. It does go out a bit more. Pretty much there's 3 layers of pedestals each time going out and raising up. But for the moment, I actually only need tier 1. And from what I saw, it actually only goes to tier 2, which is kind of weird in my opinion. Like, even the highest level stuff, it only requires a total of 12 pedestals, not the full 18. So I'm not sure what's up with that, but also need some dirt. I'm just running back and forth a lot. And yeah, I will need to come back here for the next part too. So this is kind of counterproductive to have so much running around. And I actually meant to put this back into the bag here because I emptied out all the brown stone, which is probably somewhere clogging up chests because I don't know where it went. But yeah. So if I come out here, and now I can go like this and that, and we can kind of see this area taking more shape. Okay, so this is what the summoning area looks like with 2 layers of pedestals, all 12. I don't think I am going to go out another one to give it 18, just because, like I said, I couldn't find any rituals that really needed 18, and I really don't want to crowd this area too much. Actually, I could put the unbinding one over here and the binding over there. I didn't consider that. Like I said, I probably will set them up off camera. It was on my list of things I could do this episode, but yeah, I just kind of want to make sure I have enough time for everything. So let me just sleep, and next thing on the list, I did actually have next on list to make the bonding ritual, but I actually want to upgrade my blood sword, because as I did mention in the previous episode, the reason I'm not using my normal sword is because I don't want to level it up. That's the word. So instead, I thought, hey, why not upgrade my blood sword? I should be able to apply books, or at least I really hope so. I don't think I actually tested this, but it should be able to take books, and I have two books here of sharpness and execution. Remember, execution was the book we got in the last episode? Well, I do have a copy of it now, so I'm not using my only execution book. If I put this here and put that there, it does work. Okay. So let me just get 10 levels. I should have both here. So now if I do this, I have execution. I want to put sharpness on. And now to put execution is another 10. So I guess it's maybe just a flat 10 to upgrade the bound sword there, but ta-da. I'm not sure if you actually need the bound sword to get the shard. Actually, I didn't even consider that. So if you look here, the blood demon shard's what I need, because this is what you use to create a few things. The awakened activation crystal, which I'll need for new rituals, as well as the archmage's blood orb. And what this does is I can only hold 1 million blood at the moment. With this, I can hold 10 million. So this should be good to do as many rituals as I need. And just to check, it does still keep it when I activate it. And now it has 18 attack damage. And to be honest, compared to that, that's actually pretty close considering how powerful my Tigger Sword is. So yeah, that's really strong. And glad I upgraded it. So now I have a pretty good backup sword. And let's just rearrange that like that. Okay. So now I need to make some complex stuff, and I think I'm just going to cut to when I make it, because, let's see, this is the first one. I need to make 6 of these. There's pretty much 6 different elements in blood magic, kind of like the Thawncraft elements in a sense, but just with blood magic that you make like this. They're alchemy things, and I need to use these, or make these and put them on the pedestals up there to summon a demon of the respective elements. Now, the higher tier demons require different ones, like maybe some air, some water, some fire sort of thing. But for the moment, I only need to kill the basic tier elementals and not the more complex demons. So I need to make, or my goal is to at least make 6 of each of the different elements. I have them all written down, and I just need to go through, look up the recipes, get all the stuff, and then take them over to the my chemistry set thing, the brewer, and then make them. So I think I'm just going to do that all off camera, because it's kind of boring to see me gather supplies and wait for it to brew. So yeah, let me just cut until I get, or to when I got that all ready, then we can try fighting one of each of the 6 elementals. So yeah, hopefully that will be kind of fun. Okay, so I made all but the last alchemical ingredient thing. So you can see them here. I have ether, incendium, aquasalis, teria, and terebrae. So I need to make the last one here, which is sanctus. So to make that, I need to go like this. And I thought I just would do the last one on camera so you can see the process. So it goes like this. You can't see how it's progressing inside for some reason. There's no like meter like with the brewing or vanilla brewing, but you can see it here, and it's making, also there's a recipe icon here that takes you to all the recipes, and they all do use some life points. So yeah, my life points have went down, but this is how you make all the stuff, or all the stuff you can make. I really need to look over this off camera, but that's how much blood I have left, or uses a decent bit, not too much though. Also, I did take a minute while the stuff was brewing, or whatever you would call that process, to come up here and set up the rituals, because I realized these didn't take up much space and decided to do what I said about the unbinding here and the binding there. Hopefully the demon I summon isn't too aggressive and blow up the whole area or something. I also hope the regen doesn't apply to him, but I think I can outdamage the regen even if it does to just strength and other things. So I also think I do have some sigils in here for battle. I'm not sure. Fast, minor, whirlwind, swimming, magnetism. That one's pretty good if they sets me on fire, so I might want to take that one out. Whirlwind's also really powerful, and the other sigils I'd have would be in here, which is air, don't really need. Haste is speed. I don't want to speed around any faster than I already can. So I guess the other thing would be putting on my battle armor and not my fly armor. So I can do that now, I suppose. And yeah, that was the last ingredient, and that used a lot of the catalysts I made. The catalysts, by the way, were made like that, so I just pretty much set like a stack brewing and went and did other things. So I will need my blood orb, and I'll need all of these, or at least all of these will be a different demon. So yeah, I actually don't expect this to be much of a fight. If it is a fight, I'll kind of be shocked, and hopefully it won't go too poorly. But yeah, I guess we can just fight the demon now, or the elementals. Not really demons. Elementals are like a species of demon. But yeah, So I have a bunch of blood. I won't need this stuff in the fight, so I'm going to move it there just so I can have my sigils and that stuff. So I need to put that on to activate it. So I think what I'm going to do, first I want to do the air one because I want to, because I feel like doing it first. So I think it's done like this. I never actually summoned anything before. So I'm going to activate this so I have the effects. I have a lot of buffs now, but just in case he tries to set me on fire, I have water breathing. Also, I think this does a fall immunity, which is good since I had to take off the boots. So I put this here. Ow! Ow! Okay, so I think it does that for each ingredient, just like with the rituals. Good thing I did have that fire resistance on. And let's take out the brown blade. Oh! Holy crap, that's really cool. Good thing I did put on the elemental one. So, well, he is regening. I'm not sure if it's from the potion. I would see the effect if it was on him. And I didn't get a blood shard. Or the demon shard. I didn't think it was 100%, or it might not have been. Because I expect this is something you kind of have to grind. So I didn't get it off that one. So now we can just do it again with another demon. So that was the air one, or the elemental, which is really cool. I might have to grind more of these off camera just so I get a bunch of shards. Because I realized I also might have been talking a bit loudly. I don't know, I've been recording a while, and I'm also not very good at controlling my voice. It's the thing that actually runs on my dad's side of the family. Like, you know, when you get into conversations, everyone just slowly raises their voice, and then because everyone else is talking louder, it's kind of easy to not realize you're talking loud. I don't know. So this is the fire elemental. Harder than the demon fight, or the boss fight, is getting the spirit. Where'd that thing go? Oh, I actually got it. So I did get some more ecto, and still none of the shards, darn. That's a bit disappointing. I really hope I would've got one. If not, this episode might be a bit anticlimactic. I don't know, I guess I'll just make more, because I know I spent most of this episode so far just, No, 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 no. I hate those guys. See, to be honest, they're like one of the main reasons I'm moving to a different biome. Not really, but they are a big factor of why I don't want to be here forever. Or don't want to have to do all my stuff outside anyway. Okay, so far these fights haven't been much of an issue. I still have a ton of blood. Let's see the water one. I expect it's the same thing, just blue. So what do you do? Well, that's unfortunate. I think he might try to drown me or something, but, okay, I should have put looting on this, huh? Actually, let me just stop for a second, because I don't think I have a looting book, but I'm just gonna go look. If I have to, I'll clone books, because I do have a bunch of berries, so pretty much, I want to get a looting 3 book and put it on the sword, because, I'm not getting any of the, what's the thing? Yeah, Awakened Blood Shard, Demon Blood Shard, whatever it is. The thing I need to make the orb and such. So, yeah, I'm just going to try and get a looting book real quick and put on the sword, because that might help a lot. It might not, but, yeah, so just give me 1 minute here. Okay, so I used the Bibliocraft stuff to clone a few books, and now I have a looting 3 with a couple spare, so I can apply this for 20 levels. Also, I can name this blade. It doesn't really matter because I don't need to repair it, or at least it doesn't matter in that sense because there is no repair cost. And I also realized I had it open the whole time, and that drains life points. Oops, I should go sleep. But if anyone has any suggestions for names for the blood sword, bound sword, whatever you want to call it, let me know, because I don't know, it's cool to have names for tools, and I know I commented that in the other episode with stuff, but I can name this one too, and yeah, it is a powerful looting sword. So yeah, anyway, oh, that was why the earlier the Jengu guy thing, yeah, words, that's why it landed over there, because I had the whirlwind on, huh? Okay, so now that I have looting, hopefully I can get that demon blood shard out. I always forget and stand too close. But now that I have looting, hopefully I can get the demon blood shard from this, because this is a really powerful sword now, and these elementals are no match for me. So this is the earth one. It's going to be a brown sphere, I assume. So what do you do? Oh, wow. He had slowness. This one's actually a bit hard, mainly because when it hits slowness, it limits my field of... Oh, what do you know? A demon blood shard. So that is what I needed. It looks like adding the looting helped. Either that, or it just was chance, and I would have got it either way if I had looting or not. But I think it did increase my chances of getting it, so I kind of regret not doing that from the start, especially because I knew before when I was playing this episode, I was planning to add the enchantments to the sword, that I would have a looting book, and I could have easily have prepared it to do it with the other ones if I just had a bit more foresight to that. But, okay, so what one's this? The darkness one? Okay, he doesn't seem to want to fight. I really just want to see what he does. I assume he, like, blinds me, but he just can't seem to hit me. Well, we're getting them 100% now that I added looting, so I think it was the looting that's helping. Or if I get one off this one, I'm definitely going to say either the looting was helping or those first elementals I fought just had a very low grade of what I need, or the shard. But yeah, more of these is never a bad thing, because I'll need it to make the awaken thing, and it also has a thing with Sangromancy. Anyway, want to see this final elemental, the light one. Holy. Oh, why do you poison me? You're supposed to be holy. Ah, I don't like you. Okay, so yeah, with looting 3, it seems it's 100% chance. And poison's an oak. The poison's stopped. I was going to say, and poison's annoying, so I'm just going to cut. But I guess I don't need to now. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty cool. We got the stuff I needed. Stuff and things, and yeah. Okay, so let me just put those back. So now I can do this, but I'm not sure how easy it's going to be, because I do need 75,000 blood, which is a lot. I do have a fair bit in there. I would need to top it up. I might want to grab some health potions just to be safe. But yeah, so I'm going to make sure I have everything set up here. Make sure this has a bunch of carrots. You know, just make sure I'm ready to do this, because remember before I had to go through the whole process of making sure I had all the stuff I need and that I'd get the right amount of life or quick enough life that it would work. Also, that did go so easily because I had resistance, good armor, and also a strength buff of a very overpowered blood sword. Oh. I don't really need to worry about my soul network for this, though. So, yeah. Let me just grab some potions, and then we can make the new blood orb. Okay, so I think this is all the stuff I'll need. Thanks to the regen beacon, I really don't need anything but regen 2 pots or health potions, and I really think I should be able to gain more blood quicker than it's going to use through this process. I'll probably cut in the middle just because I don't have speed upgrades now, so it's going to take a while. But yeah, if I put this in, you'll see it start draining, and if I cut myself now to gain blood, it won't even fill it to max. Like, oh, I might want to keep up on this, actually. It's draining pretty fast. So yeah, I'll cut to when this does something interesting. So yeah. Okay, so as I kind of figured this wasn't too hard, I grabbed the sigil of sight so I could actually see the process, and ta-da! Now we got a new blood orb, which, well, I actually just need to leave in here, because off-camera I'll need to fill up my soul network now to 10 million instead of 1 million, so that's going to be a lot of AFK here, and making sure that has plenty of carrots. I probably should put a hopper connected to it or something. I don't know, we'll just have to wait and see what I do there. But yeah, that's the new blood orb. This one's now obsolete, and yeah, I'm not sure where I really need to go from here, because if I search a blood orb, I believe there is one more. Come on, where is it? This one, a tier 6. I don't know how to do this stuff, but I assume that's higher tier summoning. But I also do want to make bound armor, and from what I understand, you need a master blood orb in each piece of blood armor so it doesn't cost you life points. So I'll probably make a few more of these off camera, because they're pretty easy to make. I mean, you just saw me make that one without much of a struggle, so yeah, that should not be a problem. So yeah, but before I end this episode, I actually do have one more thing I want to do. And that's make a couple more things. So yeah, let me just get the supplies ready so we can just craft them real quickly and run off the episode. Okay, so there's two things I need to make. The first is I need to put a pearl in here, and that will do it. The second thing is I need to make a book, and this is called Delving into Darkness. I believe it was like this. Yes. Oh, it didn't use the blood orb. I thought it might, but I don't use that blood orb anyway. So this is a blood magic book for Sanguomancy, which is an add-on. So it has a whole bunch of really cool stuff. It's in the same format of the blood magic book, but it has a whole bunch of items. It has blocks. Mainly it's focused around like automation sort of stuff and a corruption mechanic. So pretty much I want to make the book on camera so I could read over it off camera, and also just have it as a reference, because I'll need to reference it probably. There also is it was trying to make the next tier. That must be it. I was like, wait, why is it doing that? So this is an Ender Pearl in here, but to upgrade it again, you need to put it in there for tier 4. So since I had blood left over, it automatically was trying to go for the tier 4, which is my bad, because I didn't want to do that. Also, the thing I messed up on, I realized the blood should have drained from there, but I didn't do this to bind it to me, so it wasn't doing that. So now if I put it in there, it'll drain that. So, yay. You can put that back. So you might have saw what the block was when I went through the recipes. It's a Teleposer. So, I'm not sure. I might actually need another one of those blocks, but yeah, from what I've seen, these are really cool. I think, yeah, I need to make another two of those real quick, the Enderpearl things. So let me just do that, then I'll show you how the Teleposer works. But pretty much, it's a cool little teleport thing that I probably will also use in the tower, because in the other episode I mentioned how I want to do that, like, I guess it would be called, like, a switchback. I don't know, might be totally wrong there with that term, but, you know, where it goes down, then turns back around to go underneath. Well, it might be a pain walking up and down those stairs, so this teleport item might make it a bit easier. So, yeah, let me just, get this, sorted real quick, and make a couple more of these, and then I should be able to set it up. Okay, so I made another two teleposition focuses, and what this does is it allows you to teleport blocks on top of it. So I put this here with a button. I need to shift right click this, so it, or is it left click? Yeah, I need to get the coordinates of this one, and now if I go put this one, I don't know, let's just go out here, because I want to do a very simple test. So now I open this and put this one in here, and click this one, and put the button on that. Okay, so now if I go down here and put it on here and put a lapis block on top, and now if we go back here, the lapis block is here and we can teleport. I'm not sure if that uses blood. Let me see. Yeah, it does use a tiny bit of blood, it looks like. I think the blood it uses might be based on distance, but and here's the really cool part about it. Oh, wait, it didn't teleport me? It should be able to teleport me. Huh. I know it can be used to teleport players. Maybe it needs a higher tier focus, or maybe my jetpack's messing it up. Hmm, that's strange. I really thought I could teleport players, but I know it can move items, so this could be a cool way to move. Oh, there we go. So it might only work for one item on it. I thought I could teleport both me and this and alternate between two, but maybe because the lapis was on the other one, it didn't work right. So I don't know, but pretty much it's a really cool little block. I can use to teleport things. And the higher tier foci, I think that's the proper term for these, the higher tier ones allow for more blocks. So that is a 3x3. This is a 5x5. And this would be a 7x7, which is the highest tier. So you could move like a small house around with this stuff. So I don't know. I think it's a really cool thing, and glad I got to make it real quick and just demo it. So I guess I'll just put it in here with this stuff, because I don't know where else to put it. I might as well leave the buttons with it anyway, or with it too, also, in addition. Yeah, words. So I think I'm going to put this back in here now. And yeah, I think I'm going to call this episode here. So hopefully you enjoyed the blood magic stuff. We finally got to, or we got around to making a summoning area. Oops, jetpack's off. We got around to doing the summon area, which I will pretty later. I want to make this, I don't know, I might use like blood rune or some other really cool block to go with blood magic to make this look kind of grim and evil and summoning-y. That's not really a word. Might also do the floor underneath this so it's not grass. But, yeah. I'll make this place look better. And we can now fight new demons in the future with this. Or I can prepare to fight more demons in the future, which probably won't be much of an issue because I have this really powerful sword and the beacons. But still, it'll be cool to fight more things with it. And we got the ritual set back up. And I got to make a new blood orb and do some other cool stuff like the teleporters. So, yeah. Anyway, once again, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. And until next time, yeah, goodbye.